Blackstone Audiobooks presents The Rape of Nanking by Iris Chang. Foreword. On December 13, 1937, Nanking, the capital city of nationalist China, fell to the Japanese. For Japan, this was to have been the decisive turning point in the war, the triumphant culmination of a half-year struggle against Chiang Kai-shek's armies in the Yangtze Valley. For Chinese forces, whose heroic defense of Shanghai had finally failed, and whose best troops had suffered crippling casualties, the fall of Nanking was a bitter, perhaps fatal, defeat. We may now think of Nanking as a turning point of a different sort. What happened within the walls of that old city stiffened Chinese determination to recover it and to expel the invader. The Chinese government retreated, regrouped, and ultimately outlasted Japan in a war that ended only in 1945. In those 8 years, Japan would occupy Nanking, setting up a government of Chinese collaborators, but it would never rule with confidence or legitimacy. And it could never force China's surrender. To the larger world, the Rape of Nanking, as it was immediately called, turned public opinion against Japan in a way that little else could have. That is still the case in China, where several generations have now been taught of Japan's crimes and of its failure, to this day, to atone for them. 60 years later, the ghosts of Nanking still haunt Chinese-Japanese relations. Well, they might. The Japanese sack of China's capital was a horrific event. The mass execution of soldiers and the slaughtering and raping of tens of thousands of civilians took place in contravention of all rules of warfare. What is still stunning is that it was public rampage, evidently designed to terrorize. It was carried out in full view of international observers and largely irrespective of their efforts to stop it. And it was not a temporary lapse of military discipline, for it lasted 7 weeks. This is the terrible story that Iris Chang tells so powerfully in this first full study in English of Nanking's tragedy. We may never know precisely what motivated Japanese commanders and troops to such bestial behavior, but Ms. Chang shows more clearly than any previous account just what they did. In doing so, she employs a wide range of source materials, including the unimpeachable testimony of third-party observers, the foreign missionaries and businessmen who stayed in the defenseless city as the Japanese entered it. One such source that Ms. Chang has uncovered is the diary, really a small archive, of John Rabe, the German businessman and national socialist who led an international effort to shelter Nanking's population. Through Rabe's eyes, we see the dread and courage of Nanking's inhabitants as they confront defenseless the Japanese onslaught.
Through Ms. Chang's account, we appreciate the bravery of Rabe and others who tried to make a difference as the city was being burned and its inhabitants assaulted. Its hospitals were closed and morgues filled, and as chaos reigned around them. We read, too, of those Japanese who understood what was happening and felt shame. The Rape of Nanking has largely been forgotten in the West, hence the importance of this book. In calling it a forgotten Holocaust, Ms. Chang draws connections between the slaughter in Europe and in Asia of millions of innocents during World War II. To be sure, Japan and Nazi Germany would only later become allies, and not very good allies at that. But the events at Nanking, to which Hitler surely took no exception, would later make them moral co-conspirators, as violent aggressors, perpetrators of what would ultimately be called crimes against humanity. W. H. Auden, who visited the China War, made the connection earlier than most. And maps can really point to places where life is evil now. Nanking, Dachau.
William C. Kirby, Chairman, Department of History, Harvard University. Introduction. The chronicle of humankind's cruelty to fellow humans is a long and sorry tale. But if it is true that even in such horror tales there are degrees of ruthlessness, then few atrocities in world history compare in intensity and scale to the rape of Nanking during World War II. Americans think of World War II as beginning on December 7, 1941, when Japanese carrier-based airplanes attacked Pearl Harbor. Europeans date it from September 1, 1939, and the Blitzkrieg assault on Poland by Hitler's Luftwaffe and Panzer divisions.
Africans see an even earlier...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.